Right, this is Ben Jones. It is Absolute Radio, and we were supposed to team up on Saturday night. It was raining. We ditched it because we'd much rather hang out in a hotel. Chester Bennington, good to see you.
This is a much better environment here.
Quintessentially English. We got tea, we got biscuits, and it's all good.
It's all good.
How are you feeling post the weekend?
We got a hot pink, purplish couch.
This is my rider. I insist on the hot pink couch.
I like the fact that it matches the fuzzy balls on the ends of these microphones.
Thank you very much. How are you feeling post the weekend?
I'm feeling good. I happened to catch a little cold over the weekend, but you know, nothing to bring me down. It's all good.
I think those people who know what you're up to at the moment know that we're sort of coming to the end of the promotion for the current album from Linkin Park, and the performance at Sonosphere was pretty much the end of Linkin Park for the time being. But you're not going on holiday. You're not having a vacation. You're not doing all the things that you should do because you're going back to work with this. Do we call it a side project or is it just part B?
Well, I think part B is probably a pretty good idea. If it was a side project, I would say I probably wouldn't be promoting it very hard. I'd just be putting it out there. This is something I'm very passionate about. I have a great band called Dead by Sunrise. We have an album called Out of Ashes coming out in October. I feel like we've made a really good record. We played a few songs at Sonosphere. It was fun. It was challenging to go out and play new music in front of people who had no idea that they were going to be seeing it, nor did they know the songs. So it's always fun to watch people listen to something for the first time and play games with yourself. You know, what are they thinking? You know, do they like it? Do they not like it? You know, and then you get over yourself and you start to just enjoy playing music.
But how do you find the time and also juggle the responsibilities of doing Linkin Park and the new band? Because I read that some of these songs were written even before Minutes to Midnight was written. So how did you decide, well, this is for Linkin Park and this just doesn't seem right for Linkin Park?
It was pretty easy, actually. The songs I was writing were really, they had such a different feel. Some of them were really grungy. Some of them had this kind of Walking in Circles has this kind of Spanish flair, 6/8 time. It's a little swingy, and it just felt more like grungy and dirty. And that element of it, I think, sets it apart from Linkin Park. I write pop songs, you know, and that's what I'm good at. So I kind of combined this with the help of my band, who are very good in the electronic pop scene. We took this like electro pop alternative style and we mixed it with the grungy, straightforward rock and roll kind of thing, and developed the sound. And it actually kind of really is very apparent that it's not Linkin Park. And we just decided, you know, early on I went in thinking this is gonna be my solo project and this is gonna be my solo album and, you know, perhaps I can start a solo career out of this thing. Not that I would leave Linkin Park ever. But it would be fun to be able to do something when, you know, Linkin Park isn't doing something. And that kind of got spawned with a little nudge from Ryan Chuck, one of my guitar players. But after I brought the songs in, we started kind of messing with the songs and they started adding their influences into the music. And they became less mine and more ours. And so we decided to turn this into a real band and make this, you know, a real deal.
And where did you go to? Where did you go to find the new members of this band?
Well, I met Ryan and Amir in Orgy. They were both in Orgy when Linkin Park was making Hybrid Theory. Orgy was making their second album. Met Ryan and just became like instant friends. We became, you know, best buddies the second we said hello to each other. And you know, so we'd be hanging out and I'd be writing songs. And, you know, he'd hear me pick up my guitar and my acoustic and start singing these, you know, grungy pop ballads. And he was like, what is that? That's, you know, and I remember Let Down was one of the first songs that he'd heard. And I said, you know, these are just songs I'm kind of kicking around. He's like, you need to not kick those around. Either give them to Linkin Park or do something with them on your own. And so I was like, okay, you know, you're right. I'll do something with these. And he and Amir were no longer in Orgy at that time. And they were working on a new project called Julian K, which is their band. And it just kind of, I said, okay, well, why don't you guys help me produce my solo record? And that's how it started.
Where do you see the rest of Linkin Park going? You feel that maybe there's going to be a little break while you're working on this. The band will continue at some stage. Is that right?
We are actually making a record right now.
You are the busiest man in the world, aren't you? Seriously, when do you have time to take a holiday?
I kind of always am on. I feel like I'm always on holiday. I actually
Does it ever feel like work?
I actually wonder sometimes, like, I think to myself, like, I don't fucking do anything. I'm like, I don't do anything, you know? But then I realize, you know, I have four kids. I have a family at home. I own five tattoo studios, and I have two bands, and I'm like, I think I actually do stuff. It just doesn't feel like it because I love everything that I do. You know, I kind of consider, when I think of work, I think of, you know, dragging your ass out of bed and going and like doing something you don't want to do to make money for somebody else that's you'll never meet. And that kind of feels like work to me. This isn't, you know, none of the things I do really feels like work. They feel more like hobbies.
Have you ever toyed with the idea of doing full sort of movie soundtrack work? Because, you know, you only have to watch a film. Well, Michael Bay's clearly got a hard-on for Linkin Park. I mean, you know, clearly. I just wonder whether you ever fancied doing that kind of thing for a whole movie.
I think it would be great. I think it would be really fun. It's a different mindset, and it's a different way of being creative. And I think that trying, you know, for me, and I know the guys in Linkin Park, and I know the other guys in Julian K, like... you know, the Julian K guys, they did the music for the Transformers video game. And I got them connected through the first movie and all that kind of stuff. So it was really interesting. It's fun to go out and try new things. It was really cool to watch them take New Divide as a song for the soundtrack, want to insert it in all of the movie like they did with What I've Done, and then turn it into, like, go into studio with Hans Zimmer and make it part of the score. It was great that wasn't the original intention, that it kind of just evolved into that. That's when it's the most fun and spontaneous.
You spend ages playing. What do you actually listen to when you got a little bit of downtime? Do you listen to just sort of pop and rock, or do you listen to other types of music as well?
I listen to lots of different kinds of music. I kind of go through phases where, you know, sometimes I kind of get nostalgic and I go back and I listen to stuff I listened to for many, many years, you know, or stuff that I forgot I listened to. But recently, I can tell you the most recent stuff I've been listening to. Phoenix, their new record is amazing. Metric's new album is awesome. Cage the Elephant has a stunning album. I think Dead Weather is really, the Whorehound is a great album. It's really growing on me. So there's a lot of really cool stuff I'm listening to right now that I think I got a chance to see Tom Morello's new band perform with Jane's Addiction and Nine Inch Nails in the States. And I thought they were great live. I thought they were really cool. So there's a lot of good stuff coming on right now in terms of new music. I love Empire of the Sun and MGMT, and there's a lot of, like, really good.
The 80s is coming back, isn't it, in music? It seems like that to us.
It feels like the 80s is coming back, but in a good way. Like,
we haven't got the neon socks.
It doesn't feel nostalgic at all. It feels actually fresh and new. It feels like MGMT. I mean, there's some 80s-esque stuff, but there's like 70s stuff. There's like some throwbacks to, like, you know, early Rolling Stones and their stuff. So it's just really kind of cool that pop is kind of emerging back into rock music in a good way, you know.
When are we going to see Dead by Sunrise playing live in the UK? Any plans?
We're looking. We'd like to get out here, you know, around the release date of the album. So that'll be in October.
I think it's like
the
13th
or something. I can't remember the date, but you know, as soon as we get the venue, we'll let you guys know.
All right. Listen, it's been great to see you.
Thank you
for tea and biscuits on a bit of a cold gray Tuesday afternoon.
It looks like the sun's starting to peak out for a minute, so you might want to take a picture because you guys may never see it again.
Go enjoy summer 2009. Great to see you. Sonosphere was superb.
Thank you very much.
And thank you very much for your time.
All right, take care.